Hi and welcome back to another quick tip tutorial about low poly modeling in ZBrush. We're going to create something like this completely in ZBrush without using any cut brushes or commands. So let's get started. Press comma on the keyboard, go under tool, double tap on Z-sphere, press comma to close the library, and go down under geometry. Go to lower subdivision level and delete higher and reconstruct subdivision until you get a cube. Then make a polymesh 3D out of it and under polygroups set maximum angle tolerance to 1 and group by normals. So if you turn on polygroups by Shift F, you can see each face is a different polygroup. Control Shift makes make sure you have select rectangular selected and select this face. Control click on the canvas to make it masked. Control Shift click on the canvas to make everything visible again. Control click on canvas to invert the mask. W on the keyboard, go to Move Transpose tool. Tap on the face that is unmasked and now hold Control, drag out, hold Shift to make it snap to one axis, and here you go, you have a nice extrusion and a new line is created in your subtool. So I'm going to do the same thing again on this face. Control, click and drag, holding Shift to snap to one axis, and now Control click and drag on the canvas to get rid of the mask. Q on the keyboard to go back to draw mode. Control Shift and click on this point now that is created on this face. It's easier to select one polygroup and hold Control Shift and make sure you have select rectangular selected. Hold Alt and hide these polygons. Control W to make everything visible into a separate polygroup and Control click on the canvas to mask it. Control Shift click on canvas to make everything visible. Control click on the canvas to invert the mask. W on the keyboard, tap on this face, hold Control, click and drag on this little circle, holding Shift you extracted only this face, and now we have our base created. But if we turn on the polyframes and polygroups, we can see we have the distribution of points. It's really not uniformal, so we're going to redo this under subtool, remesh, turn off symmetry. I will use 64 for the resolution and polish 0 and remesh all. It created a new poly subtool and it has really nice distribution of points. So now I'm going to just select different faces and Control W each time, so I get different polygroups for each face. So as you can see, you can easily select different faces by this tool, because it will only show the faces, the polygons that are completely in the green selection area. So let me see, this is also one group, so I'm going to hold Alt now to get rid of that and Control W to make it this one polygroup, and now I'm going to again Control Shift Alt Ctrl W, and I have all the different polygroups that I need. So now if we would subdivide it, Ctrl D on the keyboard, we can see we get these edges a little bit deformated, but if we would like to keep them sharp, we can make use of these polygroups that we just created. So we can go down to geometry, crease, and click on crease polygroup borders. And now if we subdivide Ctrl D again, we can see we kept the edges really sharp while the number of points increased. Now we're going back down to lower subdivision level, and we're going to delete higher. It is really important for the next step that you don't have any subdivision levels, or it won't work. So Ctrl Shift click on this face to make it selected, Shift F to make everything the polygons visible, Ctrl Shift and Alt to get rid of some of them. And now I'm going to Ctrl W to make a separate polygroup for this one. Ctrl Shift click on the canvas to make everything visible again. W on the keyboard to go to Move Transpose tool. Hold Ctrl and tap on the newly created polygroup. It will mask everything else. And now if you would just click and drag upwards, you can see even if you hold Shift, it extruded, but these corners really don't look good. So we're going to, if it would do the same if we would do it inwards, so we're going to use Ctrl and click and drag on this middle circle, holding Shift to snap it to one axis and let everything go. And as you can see, the corners are really sharp. And the nice thing is that ZBrush created newly created polygons, the same polygroup as here, and these polygons are really stretched. So we're going to use Ctrl Shift and slice curve, and we're going to just slice it through two times, and then Ctrl W to make everything into one polygroup again. We can even go further by Ctrl Shift, making sure we have select rectangular selected, and hold Alt, and now press Ctrl W, Ctrl Shift click on the canvas, and now you can see we have everything in one, in separate polygroups. So this was a quick tip on creating such sharp edged deformations completely in ZBrush. So check out the rest of my videos on my YouTube channel. Here are the three of them which are really interesting. Subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already. Comment this video, like it, share it, and till next time. Bye.